Hello, welcome to another filament review video. What? Ah, you saw the title, that's not fair. It's 3D printer inside. Welcome back. Recently Temu contacted me. They offer quite big budget to choose anything from the offer. Additionally, they offer to sponsor one of my videos. And I'm very bad businessman, so I choose the cheapest 3D printer. Additionally, I rejected the sponsoring. In this case, I can be more honest in my videos because I want to test this printer as it is. If it can print, it will be shown in the video. If not, it will be also shown in the video. Anyway, this channel already has these sponsors. Those are my Patreon supporters and the polymaker who became a channel sponsor. About the printer. This is EasyThreed K10. Portable USB powered entry-level 3D printer for PLA and TPU. Why only for these two materials? Well, because probably they can stick to the bed because you don't have a heated bed. Now, all over the place on the website, on the box, we have the warning that it don't arrive with the power adapter. We have to use our own. Voltage is 12 volts with the current of 2 amperes or bigger. Port type C, but also I can see on the picture that maybe it has the standard DC plug, but I will check that later. The build volume, 100 millimeters in X, Y and Z direction. The weight is around 1 kilogram, so you don't even have a screen, but we have to use some preset buttons on it. The maximum nozzle temperature is 230 degrees Celsius, it is equipped with 0.4 mm nozzle, and the maximum speed is 40 mm per second. From the software, we need a slicer software. They offer their own EasyWare, but also they offer the profiles for the Cura. So as I mentioned, it don't have a screen, so it will always print the latest G-code from the SD card. But I think it's time to see what's in the box. This is a user manual and first 10 pages are in English. Rest are other languages. This is the base with mounted extruder. Here we can see those preset buttons. And here we can see the plugs. USB Type-C, this is the regular DC plug. And a switch which have two stages, depend which plug we are using, we have to turn it on in one or the other position. And this is the location for the SD card. This is the Y-axis and it has a magnetic removable sheet. We have to do the manual leveling knobs. X and Z-axis, and actually they are completely equal. This is the spool holder, or maybe even correctly the filament holder. I don't think it can hold the whole 1 kg spool. Screwdriver, and I'm not sure why I got two SD card readers, probably by mistake, and there is a small SD card with a lot of information on it, including the assembling video, and the warning that the machine will only read 4 or 8 GB TF cards. Assembling images in the user manual are quite small, but there is a nice video on the SD card and also on the Temu website, and it doesn't require screws or tools. For example, I just connected the Y-axis with the base. Looks like this goes outside. I tried to figure out what linear motion they are using. Don't expect too big accuracy here. This plastic part is sliding on this frame. Mounting the X-axis. On the extruder here I can see some small opening. That's for the part cooling. And the filament holder. Cable connection, and the cables which came out from the base are labeled X, Y and Z, but just in case if you don't know, this is the Z axis, this is the X axis, and this is the Y axis. Pay attention, put this all the way in, it's a little bit hard. And it is assembled. It would be good to have some kind of rubber legs from the bottom because it is not too stable on the desk. But hey, this can print TPU, maybe we can print some. From the hardware, it is not so horrible. I mean, it wobbles on X axis and on the Z axis, but it is not so big problem because the gravity will hold it in one place. Only I worry about this wobbling on the Y axis. I think at least here it would require some better linear motion. Until the graphic is closer to the center, it should be fine, but I will be very careful with those objects placed on the edge of the surface. About the buttons, it has a 1, 2, 3, 4. This is some kind of play or multifunction button. And then it has a feed and retract. With these buttons we can move the extruder above one certain point for the leveling. With these two we can add or remove the filament from the extruder. And this is some kind of multifunction button. With this we can pause or start the printing and similar. Why is this just a filament holder and not a spool holder? Well, for example, this is 1 kilogram spool. Actually, this is heavier than the printer itself and no chance that it can fit on this holder. This is 200 gram spool. And even this is big for this holder, but you can always remove, I know, 10 meters of filament, like we have this with the samples, and it can hold the filament, not the spool. I just checked the size of this standard DC plug is 5.5 millimeters in case you don't want to use the USB Type-C. Now let's talk about the power. USB PD, which means power delivery, works on that way that this printer will ask for 12 volts. And if the power adapter is not able to give those 12 volts, in that case I think by default it will be 5 volts. So you have to check the output if it supports. For example, first I wanted to use this Nintendo charger. And here we have the options of 5 volts or 15 volts. And that's not good because I need 12 volts. Then I checked my wife's laptop charger. And it also supports different voltages, but exactly 12 volts is not between them. And then I check my old phone charger and I remember that it has a fast charging too. Where is it? And here I have the options, output of 5 volts or in this case 12 volts and 2 amperes, which I need. So I will use this one.
So let's give it a power. And this time this switch has to be in this position. I can see the light.
I will press the first button and I guess that it will do the homing and go into the first position. Oops. Maybe the power is not enough. I have the feeling that the power is not enough. Okay, let's do some more searching. Actually, I found another one. This has several plugs and this is USB Type-C. And I already checked, it has several outputs. And between them is 12 volts and 3 amperes, and this current should be enough. Okay, let's try now. About the homing method. Independent from the current position, it tries to move the whole length. So even if it reached the position earlier, it will keep pushing it. With this, it will end in the home position. Oh yes, definitely, completely different story. So that was the problem. I don't really like this method, but it looks like the limit switch couldn't fit into the price. And I have the classic bed leveling, rotating the knobs until I get that friction between the paper and the nozzle, but off camera because it is quite small area. Not too comfortable, not to cover the camera. Next occasion. And repeat this several times until you don't get the perfect friction in all four corners. And don't forget, leveling means making the build surface parallel with the moving pad of the nozzle, and not with the desk, for example. The bed is leveled and I want to lift it higher, the extruder, and for this I have to press this play button 1 second. And it lifts 1 centimeter. A lot of functionality for this one button. It's a little bit hard to see. So this is the feed button and this is retract. I'm pressing the feed button. And until it's fast blinking, it is heating up the nozzle. And when it slows down, it is heated up and I can start inserting the filament. It's heated up and I'm pressing it slightly. I can feel that it pulled the filament. And when it starts with the extruding on the other side, then I have to press again the feed and it's ready for printing. I can see it on the other side. Okay, I can stop the feeding. Ready for printing. Inserting the SD card in upside down position. And I think with this it should start with the printing. It's blinking heated up nozzle, but I think it should be already heated up. Hey, it started. Now a good habit is to have the tweezers near you and before it starts with the printing, remove the oozing from the nozzle. I was busy with the camera, so I forgot to do that, but it will be fine. Just be careful with the sample filaments, they may easily fall down from the holder.
Progress is nice, but I have no idea what is it printing, and we don't have the progress bar because there is no screen. It's printing now half hours and it looks like some kind of rocket or similar. Actually, I noticed that it can be much quieter. It vibrates on the desk. Some kind of rubber legs would be really great here. And it will be finished soon, I think. Yes. Finished in 38 minutes. And in this case, I don't have to wait until the bed cools down. It sticks quite good. I'm not sure how much you can see from the print quality on the white color. Ah yes, let's remove the raft. Okay, that was easy. Interesting, it prints. Slowly, but it prints. Now let's prepare the slicer and on G-code. On provided SD card, I found the instructions and the profiles for the Orca slicer, which is my favorite slicing software, so I will use this one. And the Benchy will be the first object, which I will prepare. Also, I checked the preview and I can see that they use the raft even here. I'm saving the G-code to the SD card, and since this will be the last one, this one will be printed. SD card is inserted and I placed below it this silicone for the soldering. It will be quieter, no vibrations. And hopefully the Benchy G-code is the last one and it will start with the printing. It started with the torture homing. The raft is finished and now it is printing a Benchy. The progress is nice, but very slow. Yes, it's a Benchy, it is recognizable now. And the quality is not so bad so far. And look at this, it's finished. And the slicer was accurate, so the printing time was really 3 hours and 4 minutes. Oh, it sticks too good. Okay. This raft is a little bit harder to remove. In the meantime, I could remove the raft from the build surface. Okay, let's analyze this Benchy. Actually, it is much better than expected. Okay, so first problem, this raft is hard to remove from this bigger flat surface. I just started, so it is removable, but with a knife or some kind of flash cutter or similar. So this is something you don't want your kid to do. I would suggest using the raft only with the smaller contact area surfaces, like with this rocket. The overhang came out quite nice. Part cooling is enough, but of course this is thanks to the slower printing. Next problem I can see here, and it looks like some kind of under extrusion, but actually this is because of too big retraction. Don't forget this is direct drive extruder and retraction should be reduced definitely. Otherwise, quite good Benchy. Next printing is a rectangle. I just want to check the dimensions. It is 40 by 50 millimeters, but almost it could be a bed level test too. Which is not completely perfect, but since I have to do the manual bed leveling, it's my mistake, theoretically. I accidentally kicked down the power adapter. At least I know that you don't have the power loss or sound function. Of course, I didn't even expect this. But look at this first layer, actually it is not so bad. In the second attempt, the first layer is finished and actually it is very similar to the first one. And this will be approximately 30 minute printing. According to printed time I measured, the printing is at 40% approximately, and looks completely fine. By the way, look at this angle on the bed. But don't forget, bed leveling is making the surface parallel with the moving path of the nozzle, and not with the desk or the base. Okay, it's finished, let's remove it. Just quick measuring, I'm avoiding the elephant foot and the corners. 50.05, okay. This should be 40. 39.90, quite good. And this is the high, but don't forget this is very rough surface. And in this case I noticed some micro warping. Not big, but it's there. Let's move this filament. I'm holding the retract button. And it's blinking, it is heating up the nozzle. And when it finished the heating, it pulls a little bit down the filament. And only now it pushed back. That's correct method. I'm surprised. Stop. Again, I'll press the retraction and that's it.
I have the review in progress of the Prusament TPU. The hardness is 95A. This is in a natural color. Of course, this is a too small printer for the whole spool, so I will cut off, I know, 4 meters of filament. In the meantime, on SD card, I found an STL for the spool holder, which will stick to a side, and theoretically it can hold half kilogram spools.
I noticed that before every printing, I have to check the bed leveling, because it always moves just a little bit. Okay, it's in. I purge a little bit the previous PLA material, and I think this digravate solder is the best part of this printer. This is now TPU, I can stop the extruding. And actually I can start the printing.
And look, it's printing TPU. I hope the adhesion to the bed will not be too strong, because usually the TPU sticks very good to the PEI sheets. I'm not sure exactly what is this material, but so far it looks okay. According to measure time, the printing is at 70%. And the dice from the TPU always rolls better on the desk, it has bigger friction. And looks like it will be finished soon, I'm not sure if I will catch that moment. Finished few seconds ago. Okay, I'm curious the most about the bed adhesion. And it's perfect. This is not super flexible TPU, but it has great friction on the desk. And the quality, surprisingly good. Maybe I can see some kind of ghosting, but it cannot be because this is slow printer. Nice. Before conclusions, let me explain you my concerns I had about the bed. So one thing is this is under the angle, but already explained. It has to be under the angle because it must be parallel with the moving pad of the nozzle, and unfortunately this is under the angle. I thought this wobbling will be a problem, because when I do the leveling on the one side, it will press down this side. And when I move to the other side, it will press down the right side. And this means when I start with the printing in the center, it will always be lower than the bed surface. But actually this is not so big problem with this printer, because even the extruder mounting is not so rigid. And you saw, it just prints.
How to start the conclusions? Well, first of all, it prints. Don't expect super high quality here, but actually the quality is better than I expected. Unfortunately, this bed leveling I had to do every time before every printing, and this may be annoying to beginner users. And actually the best part on this printer is the extruder. And let's say from some miracle we replace these three axes with linear rails, this would be extremely accurate, slow but accurate printer. Okay, so this was my experience with this cheapest printer from the Temu. If you have some other experience with this small printer, then write me down in the comment section a few lines. Thank you for watching this video, and happy printing!